Navratri is just around the corner, and while you look good, who doesn't like a sweat-proof formula to last through all that dancing all night? Hi everyone, it's Smita. Welcome back. Today I'm going to be showing you the stunning look for Navratri. And while you look good, it's also going to stay put because I'm going to be showing you a sweat-proof formula that'll last through the entire night, through all those celebrations. So if you're ready, let's begin. I'm going to start prepping my skin first with a moisturizer. I'm going to be using the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Cream. This has hyaluronic acid, so it's going to keep my face hydrated throughout the night. To hydrate my lips, I'm going to be using a lip balm. This is the Rose Lip Balm by Milani. You can use any lip balm that you have, or you can also use a chapstick. And for primer, I'm going to be using the Pure Canvas Primer. This is by Laura Mercier. This, my friends, is going to create that flawless canvas for makeup application. It's going to extend the wear of your makeup. It's lightweight as well as water-based formula. Basically, what this does is it's going to fill in those pores, fine lines, the texture on your skin. It's going to smooth everything out and create that beautiful canvas. So when you apply that foundation or any makeup over this, it's going to flow really smooth and it's going to make your skin look flawless. And while it does that, it's also going to form a tacky layer on your skin. So when you apply that foundation over this, it's going to hold on to the skin longer, which will make it long lasting. Now that we have a nice, smooth, tacky layer, I'm going to move on to hydrating the eyes. I'm going to be using the Laura Mercier Illuminating Eye Cream. This will not only hydrate the skin around the eyes, it's also going to smooth out all those fine lines. So when you apply your concealer around your eyes, it's not going to cake up. Next, I'm using a peach corrector. This is from the Coastal Scents Concealed Palette to correct some of that uneven skin tone that I have around my eyes and mouth. I'm quickly going to apply it with a brush and blend it out with my finger. Now, if you want your makeup and foundation to last through the night, you want to go for a formula that is long-lasting and waterproof. My choice today is the Too Faced Born This Way Matte Foundation, and this is in the shade Pearline. I'm going to first apply it with my finger and then blend it out with a damp sponge. Now, as you can see, although it says it's a matte foundation, it still gives you that natural, beautiful glow, which I absolutely love. What I personally love about this foundation is it's almost undetectable. It gives you that super natural finish and it's also oil-free. Next, I'm going to be using the ColourPop Concealer in the shade 200N, which is a deeper shade, to cream contour my face. I'm mostly focusing this in the circumference of the face, in the hollows of my cheekbones, as well as my nose. And the brush that I'm using is a flat top Kabuki brush by DoColor. And then I'm going to be using the Milani Concealer in the shade 145, which is a true match to my skin tone in areas where I use the color correction. And that'll conceal the peachy tones, and I'm going to be blending it out with the same damp sponge that I used for the foundation. To blend everything together, I'm going to be setting my face with the MAC Studio Fix Powder. This is in the shade NW35. And then using the Benefit Super Setter, I'm going to lock my base makeup. Basically, this is a setting spray. When you spray it on your face, it's going to first form a tacky layer over the makeup and then it's going to dry up, holding everything in place. It'll stay put. It won't move no matter how much you dance or celebrate. For my brows, I'm going to be using the Benefit Precisely My Brow Brow Pencil in the shade 4.5. I'm only focusing on the sparse areas. And then to seal my brows, just so the brow hair stays put, I'm going to be using the Laura Mercier Brow Gel over this. To clean up underneath the brows, I'm going to be using the concealer again, but I'm not going to be using it as a primer on my lids. I'm just going to leave it blank. And the reason I didn't prime my lids is because I'm going to be using a fast-drying smudge-proof liquid eyeshadow. This is in the shade Eclipse, and it's so easy to use this. It comes with an applicator, so you apply directly on your lid, and you'll have to be quick to blend out the edges because it's very fast-drying, so you have to make sure you've diffused out the edges so you can use other eyeshadows to blend in. And then from the Cuffs and Lashes, it's So Me palette. I'm going to be using the shade Influential, which is a deep brown shade. With a blending brush, I'm going to blend out the edge further just so there's no sharpness left and it blends into my skin tone. And then I'm also going to smoke it out in my lower lash line. To add a pop of highlight right in the center of the lid, I'm going to be using the ColourPop Super Shock Shadow in Catitude. And then I'm using my favorite Aqua Resist pencil in black from Makeup Forever to tightline. And this is my favorite because it's a waterproof formula. It glides beautifully and it's intense. I'm next using a black eyeshadow. This is called Freak to intensify the outer corner, both in my top as well as lower lash line. Using the Ofra highlighter in Blissful, I'm going to highlight the inner corner as well as brow bones. That's going to attract more light towards your eyes and make it look bigger and brighter. And it'll also look great in pictures. Finishing up with some mascara, I'm going to be using the Lash Paradise from L'Oreal, one of the best drugstore mascaras, and has a waterproof formula. So no matter what, it's not going to budge. And if you're going to be using false lashes, go for something that's lightweight so it's more comfortable. I'm going to be using the Ardell Natural Lashes in the shade 117. And if you want to know, I use Star Glue for my false lashes. It's the only one that I use. It's fast drying, it's comfortable, not messy like the other glues. And I'm going to include a link in the description box, so do check that out. Using the Cuffs and Lashes Chisel Palette, I'm going to be using this shade of contour to deepen my contour and warm up my face just a tad bit. And for blush, again, I'm using Cuffs and Lashes. I'm using Just Say Cheese palette, and I'm using this shade of blush. And I like to apply it higher up to get that lifted effect. But if you like a more rounded look, you can also apply it on the apples of your cheeks. I'm going to be using a Pretty Peach lipstick. This is the Lippy Sticks from ColourPop in the shade Nice Things. And then I'm going to be setting it with just a tad bit of translucent setting powder to make it smudge proof and long lasting. To stay true to the theme, I have some oxidized jewelry on, and I'm also going to do the three dots on my chin. Nice thing about any look is you can alter it the way you want according to your preference. And here is the completed look. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. As always, if you did, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing. I post several times a week. Do check out the description box for all the products that I use today, along with my social media links in case you plan to follow me there. Happy Navratri to everybody. I love you guys so much, and I will see you soon with a brand new one. Bye guys.